Good morning. Our lecture today is an introduction to slide preparation. Preparation of the specimen for microscopy. Various techniques have been developed to prepare tissue for study so that they closely resemble their natural living state. The basic procedures are modified depending on the nature of a specimen and the type of microscope to be utilized for examination of structure of particular interest. So in the oral histology, we used the slide and light microscope to study the histological section in oral histology. We have four techniques used in oral tissue preparation are usually used for light microscopical examination. These are, first, paraffin embedded section of soft tissue, which is the most popular type of section used in histology. Second, decalcified section for hard tissue. Third, ground section for calcified tissue, mean calcified tissue, enamel, dentin, and a bone. Four, a frozen section for soft tissue, which is usually used. First of all, the preparation of paraffin embedding section of soft tissue. This is the most common technique, as we said before, used for soft tissue such as gingiva, cheek, tongue, lip, salivary gland, and etc. That is, the tissue which are not calcified, mean the soft tissue only didn't contain calcified material, which is hydroxyapatite crystals. The steps for the preparation of paraffin embedded section include, first, fixation of the soft tissue. Second, processing of tissue by dehydration, clearing, and infiltration. Third, embedding. Fourth, sectioning of the specimen by microtome. Five, mounting of the cut section on the slides. And the final step is the staining of the section by stain. First of all, tissue fixation. Fixation is a complex series of chemical events that differ for the different groups of substance found in the tissue. The aim of the fixation, why we need fixation for the tissue? First of all, to prevent autolysis and bacterial attack. After we remove the tissue from the oral cavity, this tissue may be autolyzed and or attacked by bacteria. So to prevent this autolysis, we must be put it in the fixative material. Second aim is to fix the tissue so they will not change their volume and shape during processing. Third, to prepare tissue and leave it in a condition which allow clear staining of section. Clearing is the next step after fixation. Fourth, to leave tissue as close as their living state as possible, and no small molecule should be lost from this tissue. Fixation is coming by a reaction between the fixative material which is used and the protein which form a gel. So keeping everything as their in vivo relation to each other. In vivo mean like inside the living tissue. The factor affecting fixation. First, pH. Second, temperature. Third, penetration of fixative material inside this tissue. For the volume of tissue, large specimen, small specimen. According to the previous factor, we can determine the concentration of the fixative and fixation time. Types of fixative used during fixation: acetic acid, formaldehyde, ethanol, glutaraldehyde, methanol, and uric acid. In lab, we usually use formaldehyde for as a fixative material. Second process of paraffin embedding technique after fixation is the tissue processing. The aim of tissue processing is to embed the tissue in a solid medium, firm enough to support the tissue and give it sufficient rigidity to enable thin section to be cut, and yet soft enough not to damage the knife or tissue. In this process, we put the tissue inside the paraffin wax to enable for cutting this tissue and didn't damage by knife of the microtome. Stage of processing include dehydration, clearing, and infiltration. The first step in tissue processing is the dehydration, to remove fixative and water from the tissue and replace them with dehydrating fluid. There are a variety of compounds, many of which are alcohol. Several are hydrophilic, so attract water from the tissue. So we need dehydration to remove the water from the tissue. In the paraffin wax method, following any necessary post-fixation treatment, dehydration from aqueous fixative is usually initiated in 60% to 70% ethanol, processing through 90% to 95% ethanol. Then two or three changes of absolute ethanol before proceeding to the clearing stage. So we use alcohol from the 60% until reach to 90% to remove the water. Clearing and infiltrated, replacing the dehydrating fluid, which is the alcohol, with a fluid that is totally miscible with both the dehydrating fluid and the embedding medium, which is the paraffin wax. This process is called clearing, since the tissue become transparent in xylene. So we put the tissue inside the xylene to become transparent in later stage. Then the specimen is placed in a suitable container of melted paraffin wax, which has been in an oven at 65 degrees centigrade until it is completely infiltrated. The infiltrated process is done in order to distinguish the overlapping cells in a tissue and the extracellular matrix from one another. Second step is the embedding. It's the process by which tissue are surrounded by a medium such as paraffin wax, which when solidified will provide sufficient external support during sectioning. So in this stage, we put the tissue inside melting wax, and then this wax is frozen, and then we can use the tissue with this paraffin wax during sectioning. Once the tissue is impregnated with the paraffin, it is placed into a small container covered with melted paraffin and then allowed to harden, forming a paraffin containing the tissue. The specimen is now ready to be sectioned on microtome. This is the block of paraffin wax with the tissue. This is large specimen, this is small specimen covered with paraffin wax. This is the container, put it here, and this can take it to the microtome for section. Cutting. The paraffin block are sectioned with a microtome, which is a device supplied with a stainless steel plate and an arm that can provide us with equal increments of the tissue. The thickness of this tissue usually from 4 to 10 micron in thickness. Then sections are placed on A pre-cooled glass slide permitted to come to room temperature and stain then with a specific dye or treated for histochemistry. This is the device used in cutting the tissues. This is the microtome, and this is the tissue block, and this is the blade, and this is the arm which is used for cutting this tissue by this blade. Mounting the cut section. After sectioning, the sections are placed, mounted on the glass slide, coated with suitable adhesive material. The slide is then allowed to dry before staining with water-soluble stains for light microscopical study. This is the slide staining by H&E stain or special stain in histochemistry. We usually use hematoxin and eosin H&E stain in oral histology or oral pathology. H&E is a charge-based general purpose stain, hematoxylin stain, acidic molecule, shade of blue. The hematoxylin gives a blue stain, and eosin stain, basic material, shades for red or pink or sometimes orange. H&E stain are universally used for routine histological examination of tissue section. This is the hematoxylin stain, and this is the eosin stain, and this is the end result, which is H&E stain. Other type of section is the decalcified section for hard tissue, a ground section for calcified tissue, and the frozen section for soft tissue. Decalcify section for hard tissue. What's the mean of hard tissue? Mean the enamel, bone, dentin, cementum. The specimen in this section must be decalcified. What's the mean of decalcify? We removed the minerals from the tissue by acid. This type is used for the tissue containing bone or teeth. The enamel of the tooth contain 96% of minerals, which is hydroxyapatite crystals. So it is completely destroyed if decalcified. Unless it is not fully formed, it can be seen. So the enamel, the only hard tissue we can't study by decalcified section, only study the enamel matrix, because it contain 96%. When we use the acid, it's appear as enamel space. So we use another section which is the ground section. The ground section for calcified tissue, the specimen of calcified tissue may be ground into thin section, such as bone and undecalcified tooth. Undecalcified mean without decalcification. This is done by slicing the undecalcified specimen into a section of about 30 to 50 micron. So is the thickness of this section is greater than the paraffin wax section on a revolving stone or disc, and then by grinding on a lathe wheel or flat stone. Without staining, put this section on the slide and study under the light microscope. So this ground section is usually used to study the enamel structure, while decalcified section may be used for dentin, cementum, bone, and when the enamel is not fully mature. The last technique or section is the frozen section for soft tissue. This type is used to examine the pathological tissue specimen immediately. Sometimes we take the biopsy from the patient, and we need immediately to study this tissue or during operation to study the tissue, if it is malignant or benign tumor. So we use this frozen section, frozen the tissue, and then cutting with the spacement of this tissue by frozen, which is a frozen, and section with freezing microtome, special type of microtome called cryostat, without being embedding inside the paraffin block. So this is used for pathological, not for normal oral tissue. That's all for this lecture.